All right, so this monologue is totally on the fly, supplemented with a handful of documentaries that I've been watching lately. But generally speaking, I think that we got it all wrong when it comes to what World War III would potentially look like. There's just too many ways now that the nuclear card needn't be played, and that the instigating country can mask their offensive with a variety of asymmetrical tactics. There's four main ways that come to mind. I'm sure there's a lot more, but that come to mind to me right now that would do catastrophic damage and lead to an immense loss of life without ever having to drop a nuke. And those four ways are as follows. So you have your economic warfare, which ranges from tariffs to embargoes to sanctions on particular countries. You have an increasing potential for cyber attack as everything is wired in to the emerging 5G smart grid. You have, of course, the potential threat of man-made electromagnetic pulse, which could cause by the high altitude detonation of just a handful of nuclear weapons, which is definitely the least asymmetrical and most incriminating offensive, which is one of the few on this list that would potentially lead to a nuclear counteroffensive, but that's not 100% true either. There's a variety of ways that it could play out that a rogue nation or a rogue group could pull this off. Because there wouldn't be immediate casualties, this would diminish the imminence and significance in the minds of the populace, which may create some ethical debate around a nuclear counteroffensive. Now, that's not the point of this video. The point of this video is to talk about bioweapons. Now, there has been times throughout history where this has been a hot topic, because it should be, because this really is how World War III is going to start. Even a dedicated terror cell who is self-taught on the internet, if they wanted to go kamikaze, they could cause some significant damage. Never mind the research programs of nations, which are most definitely kept in secret. Now, there's been programs by the Russians and, of course, the United States, which have been suspended, but we would be naive to think that this research was not ongoing. Indeed, there's research that's ongoing in plain sight, not always for militaristic purposes, but to think that this technology is not being refined in ways which are going to be devastatingly lethal and very targeted would be very naive. Now, if you were, say, a country like China, who had a population which was fairly genetically homogeneous, there's definitely a lot of diversity throughout the Chinese Empire and the countries that it's annexed, but it's not impossible to imagine a virus which would not affect people with Chinese DNA and would just affect everybody else. And of course, that's what you would need if you were talking about attacking a Western country. But the problem with that scenario is that suspicion would be immediately raised as to, well, why is it that everybody except the Chinese are impacted by this, when the majority of viruses, bird flu, are emerging in the Eastern countries due to overpopulation, overcrowding, and poor sanitation in some places. And because some of these countries have such large populations, which they might just think are expendable. So if you have a population which is 1.3 billion people and you lose 60% of that population, in some ways you may even become more powerful. As dark of a thought as it may be, as we enter the age of automation, there's going to be a lot of people out of the workforce in these developing countries where robots are taking all the jobs. So a bioweapon which was finely tuned to be just slightly less lethal towards people of the Chinese genotypes, but more lethal to everybody else, thereby giving the Chinese an advantage when the smoke cleared, because if their own population is heavily impacted by this, it becomes harder to point fingers and to attribute blame. And of course, this would significantly diminish the Western economies and the populations. And then they come in with a cyber attacks, potentially an EMP, some tactical nukes, and they're able to get control of the entire country with a very limited nuclear exchange. And they could pull this off with espionage, sophisticated sleeper cells, assassinations, and things of that nature. This is just theory. This is just hypotheticals here. Now, another thing that potentially happened is that they inoculate part of their population. And we're going to say any country, because it's not just China that would initiate this. It very well could be the United States who initiates this. You know, we always think that we're the good guy and they're the bad guy, but nothing is as cut and dry. Okay, it's nice to think that, yay, we're the best and we're all well-meaning and all the rest, but hey, there's two sides to every story. So it could well be that we are the aggressors in this instance. So it could be that we inoculate a certain part of our population, knowing that, you know, there's going to be collateral damage, self-inflicted collateral damage. But to me, this seems like the more likely scenario, because if you want to preserve all of the infrastructure, if you don't want to go the route of scorched earth and destroy everything that man has created, you get very similar effects like the neutron bomb, in that you preserve everything so that a army can go in there and commandeer everything and actually have some spoils of war to boast about when the smoke clears. Because we need to keep in mind that any power-hungry psychopathy that is in the upper echelons of society is in an expansivist mindset. They don't want to contract unless it means that it gives them more power, wealth, and capabilities. If a significant portion of the population is culled, and that has the effect of empowering elitist members of society, then that's what will be done. A World War III nuclear mad exchange does not do that, which is why it's in none of the wealthy's interest to do that. They're already in power. They get their power from the existing paradigm. The only reason why Bill Gates is the richest man in the world, because we have this economic superstructure which supports Bill Gates at the top of the pyramid, and Jeff Bezos and Warren Buffett and all the rest. They don't want civilization to die unless it means more power and wealth and opportunity for them. So I know this is going to be a very controversial video, but what are your thoughts on this? I think that a lot of people are being misled by all this nuclear stuff, and even I'll say, although EMP is definitely a real threat that you should prepare for, without a doubt, I also think that the most likely scenario, and I've said this since day one of this channel, since 2014 when this channel began, the first flurry of videos that I did were all about how pandemic is the number one threat. In most instances, I've thought that that pandemic would be something which was naturally caused. But the more I think about it, the more it seems likely that it's going to be either bioterror, or even worse, it's going to be something engineered by a nation and maybe blamed on terrorists or something to that effect. Bioweaponry doesn't only affect humans. You can unleash different weapons which will decimate certain crops, which will kill certain insects that the ecosystems of various places rely on. Now, it's arguable that this has already been done, and it is done regularly in some instances to cripple certain economies. I mean, think about it. If you create a new strain of bird flu, you are going to significantly impact the poultry market, thereby increasing the prices and demand on beef and pork and other things. So it's not too far-fetched to think that this isn't something which would be standard practice. And everybody is familiar with the aggressive, cutthroat, and heartless tactics used by the old Monsanto company. So what makes you think they wouldn't just do something like that on a larger scale if it meant totally destroying their competitors? Just release some hoof and mouth disease, price of chicken goes up. Release some rice crop killing virus, millions of people perish, and the price of wheat goes up. What can I say? Reality doesn't care about your feelings. Thanks for watching Canadian Prepper Out. The best way to support this YouTube channel is to support yourself by gearing up through CanadianPreparedness.com or BugOutRoll.ca.
premium quality gear at the best possible price using the incredibly secure and easy-to-use Shopify platform. We offer free shipping to the United States for orders over $200 USD and free shipping to Canada over $75. So support the channel by supporting yourself.